Dear learners, this is the final part of our discussion on political socialization. As we have already discussed about the meaning, definition, nature and various agents of political socialization in our previous discussion, so let us discuss about the various forms and importance of political socialization here. We will now move towards the various forms of political socialization. Almond and Powell forwarded two types of political socialization, namely manifest and latent. As we have already discussed about manifest and latent, again, just I am repeating it, that manifest political socialization is an open process of political socialization. That means it is open for all, and it is a method of political socialization in which certain values and feelings towards a political system are directly and clearly put into the minds of others. For example, when we impart knowledge, education to our students, to our learners, then automatically or they learn something which are very, very helpful for the benefit of their future life as a citizen of the country. In this case, we may say about the directive principles of state policies, fundamental rights, fundamental duties of our constitution. And with the help of these aspects, this knowledge, we may earn, we may develop, establish a system of socialization, political socialization, through which we will be able to mold ourselves for future citizen of the country. So these civic instructions are helpful for the benefit of the political system. Then he said about the latent political socialization. Latent is a method of political socialization which is hidden. That means it is indirectly taught. It is not direct. It is influenced indirectly. It is the method of transmission of non-political attitude. There is no scope for political aspects here. And which affect attitudes towards the political system. It is deep-rooted and usually it functions unnoticed and more or less automatically. That means latent political socialization process continues automatically without any notification, without any notice, and it is influenced indirectly to the individual. For example, when the parents at home and the teachers in the school advise the children, advise the students to respect their elders and obey their commands, then indirectly they give to the children lesson in political socialization. Why? Because with the help of this advice, automatically, indirectly, they learn something which is very, very essential for the betterment of the society, betterment of the political system as a whole. Then we may discuss what are the importance of political socialization. As we have discussed already, that political socialization is an important process which no one can ignore. So now we should discuss why it is important. Why political socialization is important for the individual as well as for the society as a whole. Let us discuss. So, in establishing a strong political culture and maintaining the political stability of a country, political socialization is essential. Why? Because the role played by the process of political socialization is of great importance here, without which we will not be able to establish strong political culture. Then political socialization helps in studying society in a scientific way. It helps us to know about the social nature of man. So what are the social nature of man? and it is studied with the help of political socialization and in a scientific way. Then another important of it is it examines the relationship between individual, society and political system of a particular country. The political socialization generally examines the relationship between the individual, between the society and political system of a particular country. Then we may say that it reflects, political socialization reflects the process by which the individual learns to conform to the norms of the group in a political context. So it confirms the norms. So what a particular group confirms a norms or develops a norms, it is also studied with the help of political socialization. Then in establishing a strong political culture and in maintaining the political stability, which is one of the very, very important aspect of a political system, is also played by the process of political socialization. In other words, to maintain political stability of a political system, political socialization plays an important role. Then, political culture of a particular society largely depend on political socialization. Then we may say that political socialization process is also important for the politicians and leaders to understand the peculiarities of the political system. In other words, political leaders or the politicians generally know the process or the peculiarities of that particular political system with the help of the process of political socialization. It is also essential for the understanding of the political stability and development of the country. So, in this way, the process of political socialization carries a lot of significance in modern society, without which no one, no political system can develop in true sense of the term in its political aspects. So now I would like to sum up the whole unit of our discussion from part 1 to part 3. We may say that political socialization is a continuous process throughout the life of individual. It is static. It is an ongoing process on the basis of acceptable political norms which are transmitted from one generation to another. And it is universal. It aims the political stability and it is manifest as well as latent process. And political socialization is related with political culture, that is, to maintain political culture, to change culture and to origin political culture. So far as we have learned, we have known that political socialization is a lifelong process through which an individual becomes acquainted with the political system where he or she lives. So in this regard, again I am repeating that if you want to study more elaborately, then you may go to these books referred here. And in the next session, we will discuss about our another important unit, that is political culture. So thank you all.